Hello viewers, Six Wings here. Welcome to Let's Play Rome 2 Total War Emperor Edition. This is the moment that I have been waiting for since the release of the game. Armenia. I have wanted to play as them since the game was announced. I was very, very excited to hear that they would be included in Emperor Edition, along with all the other changes. And of course, naturally, you know, I'm barely into a Let's Play, and they released Emperor Edition, and, you know, I haven't played in a few weeks, so I am just gonna play Emperor Edition. I'm gonna play Armenia. It's gonna be awesome, and my old save game won't work with all the new shiny stuff, so I'll go over it real quick. They are an Eastern Empire, the only other actual Eastern Empire, since Pontus... Oh, also, other change, Pontus is blue. Anyway, so they... Along with Parthia, an actually Eastern Empire, the Persian trade heritage, Great Marksman, now gives you 25% more ammunition instead of a one chevron for archers, which I really like the change. It'll let me just kind of obliterate people with horse archers. So, we'll go over this real quick. Landlocked, penalty to naval recruitment. I'm pretty okay with that. Naval recruitment isn't going to be as important to me in general, especially the lands I'm going to be keen on conquering, as something like army recruitment costs. So that's... I'm pretty okay with that. I love this one here, Bridge Builders. Everyone we meet who is not a nomad, or an Arabian, or North African, or East African, like really far away down... Numidia, these regions down here, Arabia Magna, everyone we're going to associate with in the early game, other than the nomads to our north, is going to be one of Eastern or Hellenistic. Of course, there's also the Galatians, but they're the one of the few exceptions. So that's very, very exciting. Also, kind of similar to the Greek cities, was it Fierce Independence that gives melee defense, except instead, this gives a morale bonus on our own territory. So defensive battles, our units will be less likely to break. That is amazing. I'll scroll through here real quick just so you can read all of it. You can pause if you want. It's very exciting that Armenia is released. So without further ado, let me double check on this. Time limit is set to 40 minutes. Battle realism is off. Advisor help off. Show AI moves. No, I really like the new color pattern, the white and gold. I think that's really nice. So let's get started. I don't believe... I did look at the unit roster. Armenia does not have copycat legionnaires in this game, which I'm a little sad about, but not that sad about. They do have probably one of the most interesting units I've seen, and that is their elite spear is disciplined, but has frenzied charge. And that seems crazy to me, but also amazingly good at running into a cav fight and just killing everything. So if you can manage to tie up their cav, and while your opponent is maybe, like, distracted somewhere else on the battlefield, if you can frenzied charge one of these guys into his cav, they'll just die. So I'm really excited to play as Armenia. Someday I will upgrade the computer, it'll go a little bit faster, I won't have these loading screen problems. I'm really bad at video editing, so whenever I try to cut out parts like this, I end up goofing everything up and just reducing the size of the video, and everything sucks. Fraps being recording right now is not helping, but I can't help that. If I don't record, you can't see it, and that would be tragic. So, I'm also really excited to check out all the new Emperor Edition changes. This is the first time I'm playing Emperor Edition, so I haven't really dug in on my own. I haven't even really watched much that Heir of Carthage has done. And if you haven't, and I can't imagine you found my video.
Under the yoke of foreign rule, you're at last free to rebuild your kingdom. The former Persian lands, shattered by Alexander, lie unprotected and vulnerable ensure you're the one who profits from this. A rapid conclusion to your war with Ardhan is essential, and you may wish to forge an alliance with the friendly Pontians to this end. With enough haste, you may even be able to subjugate those who denied your liberty, as Media Tropatene have granted your permission to march your armies through their territories and into the heart of Persia. Such a reversal of fate will be glorious indeed. It's your destiny to take back what's yours and carve a new kingdom of Armenia for posterity.
All right. So, assent to my bold undertakings. Same deal, two provinces. And let's take a look at what we've got. So, as usual, we control Armenia. I still cannot get over how happy I am that they're blue again. We have an iron province, 50 iron, which is fantastic. There's iron down in Media Magna as well, silk here, wine. No more strategic resources north, but that's all right. I think what we're going to want to do early is secure our northern flank and get access to the sea. The Bosporus province is three coastal towns, going to be very profitable. But, especially since we start at war with Ardhan, apparently. Let's take a look at our diplomatic situation. So, Ardhan hates us, and we're at war with them, so naturally. Cappadocia despises us, but that won't matter, they won't exist shortly. Colchis is not very happy. That's fine. Kartli is not very happy. So really, we're just going to make a Tripotene we should be friendly with. Yes, we are. Medea. That's interesting. I like the new color of the cultural icon. That's really nice. Satrapy of the Seleucids, who have a new color as well. And they kind of like me. Let me see if they'll trade. Our time worth a shot. And seek a core. Beautiful. So that will at least be good for our early game. The Seleucids are here. They're actually kind of friendly with us. And we can trade. We do border them, even. Do we want to? Medea usually stays friendly with them. Atropatene is not theirs. I think we want to secure our southern border with honeyed words, and then sweep north and maybe through Bithynia into Anatolia and see what we can get accomplished there. Or Caucasia and the Bosporus. Ooh, nice. The Hellenic icon is really nice as well. I really love all the changes they've made so far. I haven't seen anything I really hate. So, they really like me. Pontus really likes me. Even though I supposedly hate them. Can't trade, which is a little unfortunate, even though I guess you can't walk this land route. What's the deal? We technically border them, don't we? We only border them technically. We have a mountain here. Wish it was a little more clear. That's just the only thing that would be really nice, is if there were a... And maybe there is. Let me check. Diplomatic, public, region wealth, region growth, no. If they just add another button on here that showed trade routes, so you can see, I'm trading from, you know, Phasis to, I don't know, whatever this city is here, Nicomedia, I think. And then I have land trade routes going here, here, and here. I maybe, like, have the black dotted line for, to show land routes, and maybe like a gold dotted line to show trade routes that you actually have. I don't know, I think that'd be a really good change that they could conceivably make. Let's go back to diplomacy. So, Kartli, Colchis, and Ardhan all hate us, but that's okay, we're going to just go this way and sweep along there. We do begin in control of the Armenian region, which means we'll get to issue an edict. I think I want to be friends with the Seleucids, at least for now. And we'll listen with interest to all you. We may even let me. How much do the Atropatene like us? Quite a lot. Would you go for an alliance? As a most humble audience. They'd go for that. Not an alliance, but they are treacherous. They could backstab us. They can't because they're a satrapy. They're jerks as well. Well, be let's welcome. At least ensure that they have a lot to lose. We have a non-aggression pact already. That has nothing to do with trade, you jerk.
And so Rachel, we love gold.
Here. Let's offer them a small sum. Okay, well, deal.
Logic has been sorely lacking in our disputations. I cannot agree.
Yeah, blah blah blah.
I am honored to
trade. They will trade with us now.
We Greeks are a realistic
they won't
folk,
ally, but they will take a non-aggression pact, so we'll kick that in.
Your words bring.
I intend to go north anyway. Let's get a non-aggression pact with Pontus. Once we have Colchis, we can trade with them as well, or Phasis. So that's good. They probably won't take a defensive alliance. No. Okay.
Inspired.
That's fine. Seleucids won't trade because they hate money. And that's really all I can do from here for now. So, what's the fastest way to get there? Really? Through their territory? That's a little annoying, isn't it? What all do I start with? Let's bring up the tab. So I've got two armies, as usual. And this dude, how much growth do I be close? How much growth do I begin the game with? I have 3. So I can either upgrade, well, I can either upgrade this or my town. I have, that's interesting. So they've changed this. That's nice. The eastern city, which you mean a royal or satrap large city. A satrap large city, public order, growth, wealth, bonus wealth, but it is cheaper. This gives eastern cultural influence, which is very nice. So I'm pretty okay with that. Slave trader, which I really don't see much use in getting. Spice market. That's going to cost us public order to get that money. Wrestling arena is going to give us public order. Now, I thought they were setting disadvantages in at level 2. I thought they had said that. Unless this has no disadvantage. I'm just going to sit here stunned. So they've actually just removed some of the costs for these. I think that's very good. I actually really, really like that. So much money. Alright, let me take a look at my iron village. So it's a village, iron, workshop? That's interesting. Okay. But I guess that's just going to be true of villages that produce iron in general, which is Tushba. We can either upgrade, and this unlocks recruitment of nothing, just provides better garrison. So it gives me level 1 armor and weapons, which really says to me I want to recruit my troops out of Armenia, which was the plan anyway. So this will give me more weapons, more money, and it will cost me food, of course give me more iron. And this will be the same, except it's more armor. Wait, hold on. So base is armor and weapons. This is shields and armor. Oh, shield maker, I could have guessed that. Okay, so I can either get my weapons better, my armor doesn't get any better, or I can get my shields better, but not my weapons. So that's kind of an interesting choice there. I begin with an animal breeder. Let's get horse skirmishers, horse archers, regular Persian cav, and then do I have access to elephants? I didn't think I did, but units for just for Parthia, so it doesn't give me any units. Animal trader. Nope, just for Parthia. Okay. That's fine. So I think I'd also heard they took the food cost off of level 1 cities. So these guys right here won't just starve to death and be very easy to conquer for everyone. The bread is now brown. Now kind of bread-colored, I guess. I will take my spy all the way up. They might try and come this way so as not to offend these guys. If they do, they'll find they have no city to go home to. So I start with noble spears, and these are the guys who have frenzied charge but are disciplined. So 2 units of noble spears, I'm not entirely happy with that. So right now I have way more power at court. Now this is interesting. Influence. Civil war. The higher the influence of the ruling party, the higher the chance of civil war. But when influence is very high, we have these, and this is just a kind of cute thing that shows what it does, peerless. It gives us very, very good bonuses when we're... And penalties. Hold on, so overlooked, respected, admired. So it gives us increasingly good bonuses the further up we go, but it will cause a civil war to break out. That's interesting. So right now, both of these guys are from our dynasty. How old is he? I don't have an age next to him anymore. How do I see how old the character... okay, I go here. Ambition 3, so he's very ambitious. Nice. He's not terribly ambitious, but he's much younger. Let's secure a promotion for him. Great. He has 30 gravitas. Oh my gosh. Vistarbara... Then the next promotion, you'll have to be his age or rank to general or higher, which will give even more tax rate. I think I'll just secure promotions for both of them. There doesn't seem to be any cost associated with it. So we'll just do it. Why not? So right now... I need formal government or logistics. To recruit dignitaries and champions. Now, in general, I expect the provinces that I conquer... Wait, there's a one Hellenic local tradition. That's annoying. Go away. Eastern. That's good. So the lands we're conquering will be mostly eastern. I'm going to go with, at least to start, they will shortly stop being mostly eastern. Stop it. And that should be something up here, maybe? Yeah, formal government. Polo, pitch, and mint. The other will be... here, which will allow me to get better quality infantry. Actually, I can't even build good quality infantry as it is. I think I'll definitely want to upgrade this once I have some way of getting food. Which means, given that I don't have any food available here... As much as I would like this... I'm going to expand this city. Ooh, beautiful. Courier post. I'm not even going to do anything. I'm just going to look at all the new stuff. So the shrine is still a shrine. Trading post gives you wealth from commerce. Alright, and some public order. Let's look at this building chain here. So this can be Polo Pitch or Trader. And Polo has no cost, but it's not a lot of public order. It's mostly money from culture. This is money from commerce. I wonder if Syracuse has a similar building that you can use to take advantage of their bonus. So the courier post will upgrade to a tax office. Wow. Or a courier station, which still seems really good. Gives public order. Gives food. Wow. Nice. Not bad. Camps seem a bit different. We have farms. Goats. Grain pits. So less food. So the most food is still going to be up here, right? 7 food. 10 food. 15 food. 9 food, but much more wealth, and then army replenishment. So this will be useful in frontline provinces where I expect to do a lot of fighting, so my armies recover better. Not bad. Either way, I need the food. I can always destroy it later. Let's get the food. And with that under construction, what can I recruit at this stage? Horse skirmishers, eastern slingers, eastern spears. Units that are generally not that good, unfortunately. So, what I intend to do... Wow, that's far. He's on the wrong side of the empire right now. So we will haul ass that way. Plus 2 public order, plus 5. Ah, so the benefit to going with the satrap's city, the basically making a province a satrapy, is that it gives you more growth and gives you more public order. So it's easier to maintain control rather than doing it yourself. But it gives you a little bit less money, and it doesn't give you that cultural influence. I don't have a lot of money. I'm going to need to spend money. I can hit this city next turn, and I may well do that. We'll upgrade all of my guys here. Because I can hit that from here, I'll get horse skirmishers. So now, having recruited everything, I think I want the library. The research rate seems pretty handy. Or I can go with money. Money is going to be very, very important. Or I could save the cash and just see where I'm at next turn. So let's start on this. Our starting units are really, really terrible. So let's gain the ability to recruit starting units that aren't so terrible. Oh, and I can issue an edict, of course. Of course I can. Wow. Okay, so way cheaper unit recruitment and much faster unit recruitment. Much more money. Running games is even better than it was. I really like this. So we're actually going to go with conscription to start, and I want to see if I can take advantage of that now. Let's test things out a little bit. We'll end the turn, and I'll take a sip of my... wow, what am I even drinking? Excuse me, so conscription is a new one. That's really good. Much better than the old noble philanthropy, in my opinion. I really like the new style for all of everything. So, Okay, no. I didn't think it would. But it's worth a shot. Now, let's try and F this guy up. Military sabotage. Let's poison his provisions. Boom. Beautiful. And he has leveled up. Wise woman or a skilled courtesan. We'll go actually swap out for the skilled courtesan, and we will just go like heavy into cunning so he can just kill everything. So stance none. So I have 1, 2, 3, this will be 4, 5, 6, great, and now we can let's build up our large city. Where do we build up the, ooh, that's interesting. So there are even branches at the village level as well. There's a lot of garrisons. Wonder if they're trying to just make early, just going really, really aggro really early in the game worse. I think it will continue to just stockpile money. Trade settlement, minus 1 food, plus 2 growth, 150 wealth, 2% wealth, versus 1 growth, 2 public order, and 100 wealth. So this gives public order at the cost of less growth and some money. But there, instead of any mobs, you still have an elite Persian archer and 2 Eastern archers, but you get 2 Eastern spearmen instead of your mobs. Still 1 unit of Persian hoplites, an extra unit of hillmen, and the same axemen. I'm going to not build anything again this turn. I will revisit the Seleucids, who now have a war list a mile long. Hey, you want to trade? I don't. Here, why don't you stop trying to.
Often taken to be a sign of deep affection and respect.
Yeah, maybe in your culture. In my culture, you give me money, and then we both profit.
I had hoped that you were a philosopher and marshaled.
Okay, go away. So he just doesn't want to be friends. That's fine. We've got 5 more units recruiting. And we're just going to do everything we can to take advantage of the fact that we have a spy here who's really good at his job. We aren't at war with our neighbors to the east, but we will be. Or rather, we are at war with our neighbors to the east, but nothing's come of it yet. Media Trapatine wants a non-aggression pact. Oh, if I forgot to offer that before. Oops. Now researching logistics. Great. So, now what? They have a handful more troops. It looks like they're not recruiting anymore. Oh, no, they're still recruiting. So now we go for poison provisions again. Dang it. Okay, well, it was worth a shot. Now I can recruit another 5 units for these, 1 more of these, 2 more of these. We're already at 17 out of 20.
At your command. On the move, my lord.
Move him over here. Pontus actually should be able to trade with me now. Oh, Pontus. I noticed that you have. Beautiful. So we have a non-aggression pact, a trade agreement, defensive alliance. Of course you're a realistic folk. Unlike your buddies down here, who supposedly like me. We have a non-aggression pact already. It's worth a shot.
My people are wealthy in intellect and do not need your goods to add to their material wealth.
Alright, so we're all set. I'm going to continue amassing money rather than doing anything else here. I don't know, maybe I should actually go with the Royal Large City and get that extra cash. Yeah, let's get the cash. And the public order. We're losing our culture battle here very, very badly. So, I'll start building up our capital. This video's probably gone on for a little while. I left my...
We see little profit.
They will pay me 1,000 gold for peace.
You have fought with honor, but it is time to start.
How about you become my satrap? No. See, I intend to destroy you. How much would you give me? Eh. I don't want to be friends that bad. I can really take advantage of my conscription edict. Trait gained, something bad. Oh, taxman. I like that. Trapezos and Pontus are now allied. Medio, Trapatine, and Ardhan. Oh, that's not any good. Forcing my hand, guys. Let's try. 2/3 chance, twice in a row. What are the odds of that happening? Beautiful. Alright. So they actually have added very few troops so far. By comparison, I have 21. They have 16.
At your command. Ready for battle.
Well, let's make it happen. Declare war. Didn't like you jerks anyway.
For you, my lord.
All right, let's continue the siege. Bring up this army, and just be really cheeky about it, I think. So, what is our percent? I mean... Mob, a couple archers. Basic axemen. General axemen. It's still really kind of pathetic. I'll just auto-resolve this and take it. Well, what'll happen if I auto-resolve? Well, that's 70% of my force remaining. Think I can do better? I have 4 ladders to go after the walls. Taking the walls themselves will be very hard. Slingers are bad at it. Skirmishers are kind of bad at it. I don't think I actually have a real advantage at taking the wall. I'll win. It'll cost me a lot of troops. I think we auto-resolve this aggressively. Claim victory. So now we can raise the city. Subjugate where they will become a satrapy. I don't want that. I can loot the city to get money, which will hurt my public order. Or you just occupy. Oh, occupying the city gives you money now. Oh, they all give you money now. What are we playing Rome 1 again? I love this. This is beautiful. So now everything gives you money. Oh, that's so good. Okay, doing it. Absolutely doing it. Their forces are trampled into dust. We can level him up. He's got 3s across the board. Well, plus 1 authority. Eh. What we're going to do is... Oh, and it gives you more gravitas per turn the better you get. So we'll give him zeal. I don't know if they've changed those, but... That's kind of cool. So now what we'll do is just kind of abuse the fact that we're standing where we're standing. Yeah, he does. Recruit 5 more troops, because we can get away with it. And then, since we're here, how's this doing? Interesting. So they've built an outskirts for me, so I can take a look. It's still the same 100 wealth, but now you can make coins. plus 5% wealth from mining. Mining must come from your other towns. Actually, what's this give? Wealth from manufacturing. Okay, that's fine. I'm surprised there's no wealth from mining, but... So this gives you wealth from commerce and bonus wealth from mining. This gives you manufacturing and wealth from commerce, and then manufacturing. Let's take a look at the tree. How good does it get? So this is your maximum money on a single building. And that just depends whether you want commerce base and wealth from mining or the other. Alright, that's fine. We will not upgrade that, because what we will do is fill out the rest of this unit. He's done, he'll head east. That's still under construction, everything is just fine. Oh, and my spy leveled up again! You are the best, guy. Military intelligence and counterintelligence? Pa, who does that? Assassination with poison. There we go. I'll drink the rest of my drink. This may just take effing forever to upload, but whatever. I'm just really enjoying looking at all the new stuff. I think the feel of the game... I don't know why, it just feels older. In a good way. With all the new icons, so I can now recruit champions. So now that that's done, let's go ahead and unlock dignitaries. Ooh, wow, that's so cool. So now I can see north of here. You can see the Sirakis and Aorsi are there. Let's wander east a bit with the spy. So you can see, they've actually been putting a lot of emphasis on raising a big army, because they are at war. Take him down here. No sign of the allied force yet. And we'll give it a couple turns to heal up. Actually, what we're going to do here is I'm going to come over here and say, you look like you need some Eastern Spearmen. I'm going to stick him back in the city. And actually, I might move him to the border so I can prepare to attack next turn. I only have one of these guys. There we go. So now I'm going to have basically two full stacks, which I've manufactured very, very quickly. Again, I'm not going to spend a lot of money on this sort of thing until I can afford that wrestling arena, because it's going to give me so much public order that it'll be incredibly worth it. Probably in every case. You get poisoned, son. Victory. Ooh, wow, he kind of crushed them. So actually what I am going to move in the direction of the border here. Before I hit this, and fill up on Eastern bad infantry. Let's end the turn. This is just so cool. I love all the options you have for your empire management, which is really my favorite part of the game. So now they will... Now they're desperate. I'm just going to say no. I wonder if they improved the ability of the AI to sense whether you are more powerful than it, and vice versa.
The words of the Oracle influence.
Who are you at war with? Chimeria.
Therefore, give your consideration appropriate seriousness.
So they want military access. I would feel better if we also had a defensive alliance. Okay, well then, if you're not willing to... Oh dear. Faltering supplies. That's unfortunate. Let's deal with that in the next part. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, please hit that like button and subscribe if you'd like to see more. I am Six Wings, and I will see you next time.